everyone, welcome back to the channel. So today the video is very interesting because it is on a topic, dental caries. And I know that every one of you must be knowing what dental caries are. So normally we say ki daanton mein keeda lag gaya, that is what dental caries is in a layman language. But technically talking, dental caries is a irreversible microbial activity. Remember this word, irreversible, okay? It is irreversible microbial activity which leads to degradation of the tooth structure. So what exactly happens, you know this very well, right? That there is basically demineralization of the enamel surface which leads to caries, and this is a irreversible procedure. We cannot reverse this back to normal condition, like without restoring. Now what are the classification of dental caries? We'll be classifying the whole of the dental caries into two bases, by the Schaeffer's, the book Schaeffer's, and by the Jordan Nikiforuk. So if we see on the Schaeffer's term, then before that we need to see the pathogenesis, just to have a brief idea that what exactly happens in caries is, whenever any sugar substance, for example, you just ate a chocolate, okay, and some particles of that chocolate just got stuck on your tooth structure or the tooth surface. Now what will happen, with time certain bacteria will come and get attached to this chocolate particle or the sugar particle on the tooth structure, and they will start forming what? Acid. What they will start forming is the acid, and now this acid is responsible for leading to caries. So are you just imagining how is it happening? You ate something which is having sugar content in it, then it just got stuck on your tooth surface, and then certain bacteria with time acted on the tooth surface and produced acid, and this acid led to the formation of dental caries. Now coming to the classification by Schaeffer's. Now this classification is on three bases, either on the basis of location, rapidity, and based on whether the lesion is new or old. If we see on the basis of location, the first one we have is pits and fissure caries, and the other type we have is the smooth surface caries. I hope you all know what pits are and what fissures are, what are grooves and what are margins, okay? So this is the pits and fissure caries and the smooth surface caries. After that we come to the rapidity. Rapidity is all about the time, okay? The how rapidly it is acting. So either we can have acute dental caries or we can have the chronic dental caries. Coming to the based on lesion type, whether it is a new lesion or an old lesion. So if it is a new lesion, like if it is occurring for the very first time in life, it is said to be primary or virgin dental caries. If it has already been happened and now it is an old or a recurrent kind of caries, which is reoccurring after the treatment is once done, then it is said to be secondary or recurrent caries. Then coming to the classification given by Nikiforuk, if we see here, it is firstly based on the morphology. Morphology means the anatomic structures of the tooth. Okay, so on the basis of structure, we have four types. Again, pits and fissure caries, smooth surface caries, root cementum caries, and the linear enamel caries. Don't worry, we'll be studying all these caries one by one. So there's nothing very difficult in it. Then first was, according to Nikiforuk, first was on the basis of your morphology. And now another one is based on the dynamic, like how dynamic the, the activity or the occurrence of the caries are, how dynamic. So it can either be rampant caries, incipient caries, arrested caries, or the xerostomia induced caries, which are also said to be the radiation caries, okay. So these are the four type of caries based on the basis of dynamics. So four we had on morphology basis, four types we have on the dynamic basis, and now two bases on the chronology. Either this can be nursing bottle caries or this can be adolescent caries. Now coming to the first one, that is the pits and fissure caries, right? This was on the basis of morphology. So now on the pits and fissure caries, this is how the caries looks like, usually in the pits and fissures and grooves of the oral cavity. If you will see, you will see these kind of caries mainly on the occlusal surface of the molars, okay? Buccal and lingual surface of the molars, that is your buccal and lingual surface of the molars. Then you can also see this on the lingual surface or the labial surface of your incisors. After that we come to the smooth surface caries. This is how the smooth surface caries looks like. As the name suggests, generally it will be on the smooth surface of the tooth, and this is how it looks like, fine. Other than that, you can see this on the anterior region on the labial surface and on the buccal and lingual surface of the molars. Now a very important thing you need to know in this type of caries is, whenever you have a pits and fissure caries, always keep this in mind. It is usually this triangle shaped caries. Why is it said to be the triangle shaped caries? if you see from the above, this appears to be a really small caries, okay? But it might seem to you that you will just rub a burr around this area and the dent and the caries will be washed off, and then you can do a little restoration. But exactly when you will start cleaning out this caries, what will happen is, as the moment you go down to the towards the pulp or towards the dentine, the base will start expanding, okay? So on topical view, it usually appears very narrow or a pinpoint kind of lesion. But when we go deep into the lesion, or when we go deep into the caries, it generally expands its base. Okay, it will start expanding, and there will be a lot of tooth structure which will be involved near to the dentine region. So it is said to be a straight triangle in which the pointed side, matlab the small opening, is on the towards the enamel, and the base that is towards the dentine is usually very, very broad, which means a lot of tooth surface is involved on the dentinal side. Whereas on the surface caries, smooth surface caries, it is usually inverted triangle. Now, how inverted triangle? If we see on the enamel surface, the destruction is very huge, okay? But when you will start to dig inside, you will see that the caries or the lesion is getting narrow. And when you will reach into the dentinal region, you will see that very a pinpoint kind of lesion is only left towards the dentinal region. So it is completely opposite to that of your pits and fissure caries. On the pits and fissure caries, usually the topical view was very small, but on digging down, we came to know that the lesion is actually very huge in size. Whereas in smooth surface caries, superficially the lesion appears very, very huge, but when we dig down, it appears to be very small. Moving ahead to the nursing bottle caries. Now you see, first thing, that the nursing bottle caries have involved all the tooth structures of the baby, okay? It is going to involve your maxillary anteriors, your mandibular posteriors, and your maxillary posteriors. The only set of teeth which is not involved here is your mandibular anteriors, okay? Your mandibular anteriors will be safe. Other than that, all the teeth inside the mouth will be disrupted. Now the thing is, why is it said to be nursing bottle caries? Before that, you should know that they are also said to be nursing caries, baby bottle syndrome, or the bottle mouth syndrome. These are some other names of the disease. The etiological factors are that the nursing bottle caries are usually happened when we have any bottle which is containing either milk, either fresh fruit juice, or sweetened water. So you remember, usually we give babies, we give the feeding bottle in their mouth which is having either milk or juice or sweetened water, and we just leave the baby so that the baby can enjoy the whatever he is drinking, he can enjoy that. And another reason can be breastfeeding or sugar or honey pacifiers. So usually people have this habit of putting pacifiers in their children's mouth. Now these habits can be very, very dangerous, especially when you do these habits overnight. You see, sometimes to make the child sleep, what do parents do? They will take the milk bottle and they will put it into the child's mouth so that he can sleep at night. And what will happen is, this as a practice, as a routine practice, can lead to your nursing bottle caries. Moving ahead, you can see some pictures. This is a picture of nursing bottle caries. These look okay. One thing you need to know here is that this particular one is the nursing bottle caries, whereas here I have got the rampant caries. If you see the rampant caries and the nursing bottle caries, they look very much similar to each other. The only difference, or the only characteristic feature to differentiate between these two, is that in cases of the nursing bottle caries, the mandibular anteriors are completely safe, whereas in case of rampant caries, each and every tooth of the oral cavity, no matter which quadrant it is, which part it is, whether it is maxillary or mandibular, every teeth is going to be disrupted in rampant caries. Whereas in nursing bottle caries, the mandibular anteriors will be saved. Now the question here is that why are these the only teeth which are being saved? When everything is getting damaged, why are they left? Now the reason is, try to imagine, your mandibular anteriors are generally, they are covered with your tongue. And whenever a baby is using a bottle to drink its milk or whatever, so in that kind of proportion, usually the mandibular anteriors are covered with the tongue surface. And so the milk or the sweetened water or the juice, whatever the child is consuming, does not come in contact with those tooth surfaces. And when these tooth surfaces do not come in contact with the juice, it will definitely not get degraded, okay? Whereas all the other surfaces are getting disturbed, but these surfaces are covered by tongue. So usually tongue is protecting these teeth. So that is the reason that in the nursing bottle caries, the mandibular anteriors are left safe, which is a characteristic feature to differentiate between the rampant caries and the nursing bottle caries. Moving ahead to incipient caries. Now, incipient caries should always be mentioned as early caries. They are not exactly caries. What happens is, they usually, when we see them, they appear to be as white spot caries. Now, they are basically early caries lesion which are visible on the smooth surface of the teeth. Now, clinically, when we see them, they appear to be white opaque region on the gingival area, on the buccal and labial surfaces of the teeth. You'll see in the picture itself these kind of structures. You must have noticed in your own tooth or maybe in your sibling's tooth. So when person is not exactly having caries, but he is prone to have caries, these are the early indication of caries, okay? If somebody is having these kind of indication, it means that he can have further caries in future. So these are the, you can say that, pre-caries kind of state. Now in this stage, usually if you take proper precautions, you have the chances of remineralization and the caries can be prevented. So this is the early stage where demineralization has just started, but proper precautions can prevent this decay and can lead to remineralization and healthy tooth. Moving ahead to acute and chronic caries. Acute caries, the name suggests, they will usually very rapid clinical course. That means the duration of action or the duration of occurrence will be very, very low. Whereas chronic caries are usually the ones which are having a long clinical course or a slow clinical course. They are going to be persistent in the mouth for a very long period of time. In acute caries, usually your children and young adults are affected. In chronic caries, adults are affected. In acute caries, the initial entrance is very, very small. That means the site of caries is very small, and here the caries is very large size. There is no tertiary dentine formation in acute caries, whereas there is tertiary dentine formation in the chronic caries. Then the color will be light yellow in color in case of acute caries, whereas the chronic caries are usually very dark brown or even black sometimes. Pain is usually present in case of acute caries, but in chronic caries, pain is never present. Okay. Moving ahead, you can see some pictures. These are the acute caries. You see that the lesion is so small in size. Okay, the size of the lesion is very small. And here is an example of chronic caries. The whole of the tooth is somewhat affected and the color has been changed. Coming to the recurrent and virgin caries, they are also said to be the primary and the secondary caries. If you see, the recurrent caries are a type of caries. For example, you have already done restoration of a diseased tooth, okay? And a patient came to you, you did restoration, everything, and he will come after 6 months again and he will say that that tooth is paining in which you did the restoration. And then you see that some kind of caries have erupted from the site of restoration only. Now this is said to be recurrent caries, which means they have kind of reoccurred. Again, they have occurred even after the treatment. Virgin caries are the ones which have occurred for the very first time. They have traumatized the surface for the very first time in life. Coming to arrested caries. Now, what are arrested caries? These are a type of caries, as the name suggests itself, they get arrested. Okay, imagine you have got arrested. Will you be able to run here and there? No. They will just get arrested stationary or static after some time, and their further tendency to proliferate is completely destroyed and they cannot proliferate further. These caries are usually seen on the proximal surface and are usually dark brown and black in color. They look very, very soft and glossy when you see superficially. So this is what the arrested caries look like. If you see the surface, they will look very smooth and glossy and soft. They would not exactly look like a carie. It would just appear to you like a brown, dark brown spot on the tooth. Remember, every time, arrested caries mainly occur on areas where there either is any kind of gap between the adjacent tooth or maybe that there is any missing adjacent tooth. Now coming to the root caries. As the name suggests, root caries on the root surface. Now what exactly happens is, You see, these are the Chappe's fibers. You can see these layer. This is your Chappe's fibers. Now, these Chappe's fibers basically act as a pathway for bacteria penetration. All your small, small bacteria, they will start entering or attacking the root of the tooth from these Chappe's fibers only. They will reach near the, you can see here, they will reach near the Chappe fiber and then they will start penetrating into the bone. And after they have reached the root, they will start degrading the root surface. This is how the root caries are usually seen. Xerostomia induced radiation caries. Now, very, very easy and very, very important. As the name itself is telling you what it is xerostomia induced radiation caries. In patients who have undergone any radiotherapy or any chemotherapy, mainly patients who are having cancer or tumors, that kind of stuff, they usually also manifest a condition which is xerostomia. I hope you all know what xerostomia is. I've already made a video. Low saliva content, dry mouth, that is said to be xerostomia. Xerostomia is basically a condition in which there is excess of the these lesions are there in the oral cavity. And you see that there is no saliva content in the mouth at this condition. These are the xerostomia induced radiation caries, which have occurred because of any kind of chemotherapy or maybe because of any kind of radiotherapy. Moving ahead to the rampant caries are defined as fast progressive type of dental caries. Fast progressive means they are very, very progressive and very aggressive in nature. They will start multiplying, or you can say they will start hampering the other tooth very, very quickly. So it is usually seen as a multiple dental caries at same time. So in one person, you can see that 7 or 6 teeth are affected at a single time only. If you will see the type of lesions, they are deeply burrowing type caries, and usually there is early pulp involvement. As I said, they are very progressive and aggressive kind of caries. That means that very early they will start moving towards the pulp, because the main objective of any carie is to hamper the pulp. So similarly here also, the rampant caries, they will start proliferating towards the pulp. For example, this is your tooth. So rampant caries, they will very quickly try to move towards the pulp. So that is why they are said to be extensively progressive and aggressive caries. They are having soft consistency and yellowish brown color. This is how rampant caries looks like. I've already told you all the tooth structures inside the mouth are missing. Only the root stumps are left, because rest all the coronal area, crown area is completely damaged and it's completely degraded. So this is what rampant caries looks like. It is very easy to identify them when all the tooth structures are completely damaged and eroded and only the root stumps are left. Then it is said to be rampant caries. So this was all about the different kind of caries I tried to explain you. If this video was useful to you, please share this with your friends also. Subscribe to my channel and also let me know your views in the comment section. Thank you.